Hello, Sejin.
Hi, Don.
Very good to see you.
So good to see you too. How are you?
I'm doing very, very good. It looks like you are a brand ambassador for Coffeesmith. Is that right?
You're totally right. You can obviously see it in my background, but yes, that's who I am.
I make some good coffee, I'll tell you that much. I remember that.
I'm not so much of a coffee person either, so I'm having some cleansing juice, mm-hmm. but that's good enough for me. No coffee today.
No coffee. Yeah. My diet's about 3 on a good day. Good being like, I want to reduce my coffee intake. It's been ridiculous.
Oh.
So I'm actually substituting with, look, some green tea. Oh, yeah.
I haven't really seen so much of a successful transition for people who really love coffee and then they try tea. That doesn't really last long, but I hope it lasts.
You know, you can't substitute morning coffee, but I think what you can substitute is the afternoon, like just out of habit drinking coffee, you know?
Right.
So that's what I'm trying to
say. I wouldn't know it because I really am not a coffee person, so... Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I don't know.
Hey, listen. I know I pulled you off on a very busy day. So, it's just so busy that you have to go to a coffee shop. So, I want to, first of all, thank you for coming on. As you know, this is my coach conversation series. I have 20-minute calls with our coaches, and we talk about their clients, their lesson plans, their recommendations and insights to just a whole bunch of things, right? What we're doing over at Dong Company. I wanted to bring you on board for a long, long time for many reasons. And I'm hoping that by the end of today's call, our coaches audience and also our client audience can know why. Just a quick bio for you. I mean, you and I, we've known each other for a better part of 3 years.
Almost 3 years, yes. I think so. Wow, time flies
really fast when you're working hard and having a good time.
Yeah.
Could you actually just add some color on that? Because I think you're way better at explaining that. You know what I mean?
In terms of how we met.
Yeah, how we met and then how we formed, let's say, a coach and business relationship.
Okay. Well, I mean, in the very beginning, I met you through a mutual friend of ours. Remember?
Yeah.
So I knew that you were coaching English, and I was interested in taking a part of it. So that's how I got introduced to you. And when I met you, I saw that you were so passionate about what you do. And I saw that how, you know, you had this big picture that you were reaching out to. And I saw the excitement when you met me. And that kind of, you know, brought out the excitement in me as well in taking this part with you at Donnelly Company. And when I started working with you, the part that I really, really, really liked about you as somebody who leads the company is the fact that you're very confident in what you do. And you had a very clear vision of your company and your direction in how your vision should be heading to. And they gave me a lot of confidence. And from that point onwards, I just trusted you in how you introduced me to your clients and how you worked really hard to find the right person for me to connect to. And that just brought out the second phase of me working with you, which is bonding with the clients and to be really a friend to them and help them improve in English. And I guess that fun just, you know, brought me to here. It's been 3 years since I've known you. I've met so many clients that you introduced me to, and I love every single one of them, and I really enjoyed talking to them, you know, taking classes with them, and I still do it to this day, and I don't plan to stop it anytime soon at all.
Yeah, well, I'm blessed to have you.
You have a
very unique set of skills, and it's your background. Would you be okay of sharing with everybody your background?
Oh, no problems at all. Okay. I actually like talking about it, so that's a good question. So I was born in Korea. I was raised here until I was 6 years old. And then my family moved to Thailand. So I was in Bangkok for 4 years, and then we moved to Phuket for another 4 years. My parents are still in Thailand. So when I turned 14 years old, me and my older sister, we were sent to England to study. And that's where I studied my secondary, high school, and university. And when I came back to Korea, my plan was to stay here for 6 months. And of course, I'm stuck, and I've been here for 9 years already. The first year when I got back, I worked in advertising agency, which was a great experience, but I realized that it wasn't really for me. So I had to leave, and I decided I want to give a go in one of the things that I really, really wanted to do since my childhood, which was modeling. So I went for it, and you know, luckily I managed to sign with an agency and actually became a fashion model, which was amazing. And in year 2012, my agency recommended that maybe I should go for the SBS Supermodel Contest. I had no idea what that was, but I thought, okay, well, that sounds fun. Let's do it. So I did it. It was super amazing, you know, once in a lifetime kind of experience. And luckily, again, I won a prize. Amazing, right? And so then the year after that, I managed to host a TV show with SBS. And it was a TV show about business and startup scenes. And that's how I got to know about the booming scene of startups at the time in Korea. Mm. And I happened to have a friend who was going for a Y Combinator. You know what Y Combinator is? Yeah, yes. In America. So they were going for that. And they needed my help with preparing things in English. So I did, not that we made it to Y Combinator, but we did make it to Silicon Valley at the end of year 2013 for 2 months. So I was in Silicon Valley for 2 months, and we attended this accelerating course. And I obviously learned so much about how to run a business, how to start a startup, and really widened my connections in that industry. And when I came back, which was early 2014, I was approached by this really successful entrepreneur who was just about to start a company in diet supplements. And he offered to run the company with me. So I took a leap and I joined the company for 2 years as a CEO. And obviously, again, I learned so much. But then at the end of those 2 years, I decided I want to pursue my career more in the beauty side. Mm. So I wrapped the company up, and then I decided Destium, which is a really big, internationally big Canadian beauty company. And they were expanding to Asia Pacific region, and they were building a flagship store in Kaesong in Seoul, and they needed some team members. So I was one of the three people to join their Asia Pacific team, and I was in charge of partnerships. Another was in charge of finance. Another was in charge of marketing. So basically my role was to build the flagship store in Kaesong, and at the same time, retail and distribute their brands into Korea and in Asia region. Mm-hmm. So I was managing and strategizing retailing on and offline channels in Korea and in Japan, in Malaysia, in Hong Kong, Singapore. Amazing experience. I really, really, really loved the challenge because it was a new beauty brand in Korea. Nobody knew about it. And to actually see it grow and have people really love and enjoy the product, it was an amazing feeling, you know. And then I joined Peach & Lily, which is the biggest Korean beauty distributor in America, based in New York. Mm. So I happened to meet the founder of Peach & Lily, and we just instantly clicked. Mm. you know, two girls sitting in a cafe talking about beauty. We literally talked for 3 hours nonstop.
Yeah.
It was such a fun time, and she really wanted me on board. And so I, of course, said yes, and I joined Peter and Elie. And my roles were to manage the brands, source the brands, and distribute them in America. And yeah, and from then onwards, I'm really diving into the whole beauty scene in Korea and in America and worldwide, really developing my career in that way. And during that journey, I met you. And I met my current client, who is also in similar industry. And that's why I think we had so many interactions that we could find to talk about. You know, there were many connecting points between us two, and that kept us going. And still to this day, the classes are happening, even later on today.
You have one tonight. Am I stopping you there, or do you have more in terms of the story?
No. That's it. That's my current situation. And yeah, I'm preparing to launch my own brand, which is great. But again, then my client comes in handy because she's already in the business. She's running her own business. And, you know, these days we share about our ideas and our opinions. And I seek advice from her as well, as much as she seeks advice from me, because she wants to obviously bring a business to America. Mm-hmm. And I have experience there. So we just truly connected, and, you know, we're just really comfortable friends now, you know. Nice. I really, really love the experience here. And that's why I plan not to stop these classes.
we met actually, all three of us, a month ago.
I think it was already 2 months ago. Yeah, time flies.
That's the thing. Time does fly. Wow, that's 2 months ago. Well, 2 months ago, I think it marked a milestone for you and your client in terms of not even just duration, but it was like the number of sessions that you guys done together. And we met for coffee, and we chopped it up. But
yes.
What I was able to see was how comfortable you two were. Like, even off,
yeah.
You know, it seemed like you guys were really just friends. So that was a beautiful thing to see and witness. But I'm so happy that I made that connection. One thing
so
I do
much for making that happen.
Well, you just said that. You said, well, you know, in the early phases, she was getting a lot of advice and recommendations from you, and a lot of insights from you, because her brand is going international. So now you're launching your own brand in preparations too, and you're also getting a lot of, you know, recommendations and ideas from her.
Yeah, yes.
So
it's amazing.
It is an amazing cycle I see, and very just unique relationship, because.
Yeah.
You know,
I mean, this isn't just about improving her English, I think. I mean, it was in the beginning, but then as soon as we started talking and connecting in terms of business, and, you know, I saw that she needed my insight in expanding her brand internationally. And really then improving her English came to improving her technical words that she would actually use with her buyers, with her international customers, when she's contracting a deal or whatnot, you know? So in that sense, I was really happy to be her coach, because I could also see that her English improved and her business is expanding too.
Yeah.
And, you know, not 100%, but still a small part of that was, you know, me helping her a little bit too. And just to see her personally grow her skill in English and her company growing so fast over the past few years. I mean, you know that too. She's been so amazing with running her own business. It's really successful. I really admire that. And the fact that we're comfortably talking about it, and we also celebrate that together. And, you know, and we came to a point where I'm needing her insight now. And it's, again, another topic that we could talk about in depth and improve our English further. I really like this relationship that I have with her.
Yeah, I think you touched the jackpot there, because you've guys been together again for a better part of 2 years. Maybe give or take a couple of months, but it's there. And I know a lot of the coaches that are watching this, is they're going to be asking, well, how did you do it? You know, what is that formula? What is that process? Would you be able to share? I know you touched upon it just now, but could you maybe elaborate on how that works?
I think in the very beginning, I tried to find, you know, any connections that I could make with her on a personal level and on her business level. And when I found out that she wanted to bring her business to America, I decided, oh, wow, this is it. This is the ground that I could, you know, build on and really connect with her. And because that was her passion and that was something I could provide as well. Mm. When we hit that point, our relationship not just became like a student versus coach, but it was more like a friend. It makes sense, right? Yeah, we just became friends. And since then onwards, the conversation became more comfortable and we really opened up our minds to each other. And we really talk about, you know, sometimes sensitive things. And of course, I swear with my life that I will keep that secret, because that's the trust that you need to have with your clients. And that's how you build on business and personal and friendship, you know? So with her, I really, you know, in the beginning found that you have to be friends with your client and you have to open up to him or her first so that he or she can feel comfortable to talk about a lot more things. And in that way, you can find more topics to talk about. And, you know, it's been almost 2 years and we still don't run out of conversations to continue. You know, we always find something new. And just being a friend, I guess.
Yeah,
is a very important part, I think.
I think so, because I'm also drawing from my own personal experience, because I have a coach, and I've been with a Korean coach for about 4 years now. Goodness!
Wow, 4 years.
4 years. You're right, and you know, I think you're right. He's also one of my best friends now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I share with him pretty much everything. He knows more about me than I probably know more about myself now, you know, really, because as he's a coach and he would ask me questions, to know more about me. And he's like an algorithm or a big data. He holds all the information, knowing what can I do with this to better serve Don or to be better coach for Don. And with that and with that care, I think it's proving to be a very fruitful and win-win relationship. And it definitely carries out for a long time, because, you know, Sejin, I've told this in many times in my conversation series, that what we do here is not a transaction. It's just completely not a transaction. And that is what separates. If anybody would ask us, Don, what is different from you and the YBMs out there and you know, those bigger companies or English companies? Well, very simple. We're not a transaction company. It's a relationship
company. Right.
So even...
I really agree with that.
Right? I mean...
I really do.
For me to connect your client to you, it requires thought and care, and really, hey, if we put these two together, would something good come out of it? You know, is it going to be a good partnership? Is it going to be a good relationship? But if you're not thinking in that mindset and you're saying, hey, it's a transaction, well, maybe that can happen for a month or two, right? But nothing more. You know what I mean?
Right.
And
so
for,
true. So
for
true.
To work, for acquiring a skill or especially a second language at this level, right? If you want to reach the fluency level or the advanced level or to be proficient in business communication, it takes time. Yeah. And having a trusted coach that cares for you and understands you and considers you as a friend, and you're trading business know-hows and resources and contacts, well, it's certainly going to help, right?
It's only going to help, and it's only going to get better.
Yeah. And yeah. Here's the thing, Sejin. If you had any words of advice or recommendations for or to be clients, because we do have members in the audience that are on the fence. So would you have any recommendations for them in hoping to achieve fluency?
I would say it goes down to the basic mindset when you try to learn something that you are not so good at. The first feeling that comes to your mind would be fear and embarrassment, I think.
Yes.
And to actually put yourself out there and to commit to learning something completely new with a stranger in the beginning, it could be quite daunting.
Yep.
But I would say there's always a first time for anyone in anything. And from my experience here, really, don't be precious. Just open your mind up and be comfortable with what you want to learn, because they will only, the coaches are only going to be there for you. And just like how I do it with my clients, we're not scary people. We're here to help you. We're only here to converse with you on many different levels. So just open your minds up. And let's just be friends and just, you know, comfortably talk and get to know more about each other. I think that is it, really.
It is a marathon, isn't it?
It is a marathon, but you know, it's just like how you make a new friend. You don't just become a best friend on your first meet. It takes time to get to know that person. It takes time to make connections with that person and to really get to know each other. And that's how you realize time flies. And, you know, like it's a year later that you find out that, oh, wow, this person actually knows a lot more about me than I do about myself. And I think it's the same process. Stop thinking that, you know, because your English isn't so good, you cannot leap on this idea of learning it with a coach. Just think of it as you're making a new friend. And that friend is going to be a really, really nice person.
Well said. I think that's a key point. Having an open mind, right? Don't treat this as, I just need to solve this problem to relieve me of my stress at work or of my career.
Right.
Think long-term, it's a marathon. Have an open mindset. You know, you're going to be meeting somebody quite regularly. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So having that open mindset is key. So I think, thank you for that. And how about our coaches? Mm-hmm. We have coaches in the audience that watch this and they want to take away some actionable strategies to apply with their own clients. So I do want to thank you because you touched on how to maintain and form a long, fruitful relationship with your clients. Do you have any other words of suggestions, recommendations for coaches out there?
I would say you as a coach, you are the person that the client really relies on.
Mm.
And you are the conversation window for them. So when you start this, you know, coaching relationship with your client, make sure that they are comfortable with you. And one way to do so is to give them absolute trust and allow them to give you the trust when you converse with them. Yeah, I really think that is very important thing that I've been feeling and realizing over the few years, you know. I think it's, as a coach, it's all about giving trust and receiving trust from the clients. Because like I said earlier, it's not just about teaching English and improving English, but it's more about getting to know that person and helping that person to grow in the way they want, for example, in business aspect. And when you do so, some of the things that you would be talking about or sharing with each other would be sensitive too. And you have to be in the, on the ground where both of you are open-minded and are comfortable to share about these things to move the conversation up to the next level. So give them trust, allow them to give you trust, and work on that friendship level, just like how the client is trying to do with you, and level up with them. And just, you know, eye to eye, peer to peer, be a good friend, be a trustworthy friend. But then during that journey, improve their English whenever they need you to do that. Yeah, I guess that is my answer.
I know, yeah. I know I'm putting you on the spot here because I don't give you questions to prepare beforehand. It's just off the cuff and right, we're just going with it.
But yeah, go ahead.
And you're saying give trust and receive trust, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are you able to count back and maybe share with us how were you able to give trust to the client? Maybe it doesn't have to be many, but if you just have one or two, how you were able to give that trust. And also, mm-hmm. if you remember how you were able to receive that trust from your client.
Mm-hmm. I think that's easy. I think that comes from honesty.
Mm.
I think that really comes from honesty and how you express that honesty with your client. Mm. For example, no one is perfect in this world. Mm-hmm. And when you conduct a lesson, there always comes a time when either the client is stuck or if you're stuck in, you know, giving an explanation. Don't panic because people don't know everything. If the client is stuck, be patient, you know. Help her research through that. And if you are stuck, don't be embarrassed and just say, hey, this is actually something that I'm not so familiar with.
Mm.
Let me get online now and research, or I can come back to you with a more accurate explanation. Will you allow me that time? Mm. And in that sense, I think then client gives you, in my case, the client will give you more trust because she knows that I am on this, you know, I am on this journey with her and I am trying to go through it with her hand in hand. And if I don't know anything, I would just honestly say. And in that sense, then, you know, I think that builds more trust between you two. And the trust doesn't come, you know, like tomorrow or the next day. As the friendship grows with that person, you know, they just find out that you are just an honest person. You are just really there to help her whenever she needs help, and if you lack in anything, you are, you know, eager to work on that to provide better accurate explanations and answers. When that builds up, I think then there is a solid trust between you two, and it creates the ground where both of you can ask questions whenever you need to know something.
I think you touched on another jackpot here, Sejin. You're just getting all the jackpots at once. That's why I wanted to bring you on, because that's a word that isn't brought up as frequently as it should. Honesty.
Right.
You know?
Okay.
And I think that's key, being honest. And if there's a, like you said, if there's something that you don't know, you say you don't know, but you'll look for it and you'll help.
Exactly.
But also, these are, I think what you're also saying here is that it takes time to create this trust, but mm-hmm. actions will build this trust in being honest in everything that you do, right? Yeah. Well, of course, there'll be an acceleration to towards building that groundwork of trust from both your client and yourself, which creates then an amazing relationship, which is what you and your client have.
It's a really amazing relationship we have now. I'm so happy about it.
100%. And that's what I want all of our coaches are listening in and all of our clients watching this to form. Mm-hmm. Once you do have that, because I have that with my coach, you have that with your client. I have mm-hmm. that with my two clients that I'm teaching right now. And many of our coaches with their clients, but new coaches are watching this and also new clients are watching this. I think it's important here, honesty, and be honest about if you can't make the class as a client, if you can't make the class, why, you know, just be honest. And, as a coach, every action you do is going to be, tracked and monitored by your client. And if it's anything less than being honest, then you're not going to have that groundwork, that relationship that we're talking about, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Awesome. Anything else?
Any more questions? I'm actually really enjoying this.
Well, I'm glad you are. I am too, because I want to get this out there. I want to, you know, a lot of the questions I do receive from our new coaches are, I think you would also remember when you're first starting off, it's, you know, it's something new. So you are, I don't want to say worried, but there is that in the back of your mind.
Yeah, of course.
Are we going to be together for the next month? Or, you know, and I know that feeling. But I think if we did, if our coaches just follow this, which is, like you said, be honest, just be honest, and be a friend, not just a teacher or coach, right? But I think that comes first, doesn't it? You know, having that solid trust, being honest, then you are able to create this friendship, which is going to be amazing.
Yeah. And then time just flies after that.
What's that?
And then time just flies after that.
Oh yeah.
It really flies.
Oh yeah. I want our coaches and clients to celebrate their wins together. You know what I mean? Like mm-hmm. when your client had a huge milestone for a company, there was a celebration. And there's all these other things that you guys do together, which I won't be going over here in this call, but I think that brings us to a close, Sejin.
Okay.
Your insights on being an honest person and creating this friendship, I think is going to help a lot of our clients. If a lot of our clients, you know.
I'm so glad I could be of help.
Absolutely. All right. I've held you on too long. Weather is amazing.
Indeed, it is.
go enjoy it, please. And I will catch up with you later, huh?
Okay. Thank you for having me. Really enjoyed this call. Let's do another one soon.
Absolutely. We'll have to see each other in person.
Okay. Yes. Good. For sure.
Okay.
Okay. Have a good day.
All right. You too.
Bye.
Bye-bye.